A tragedy has struck as Hector discovers his friend has overdosed. How can she be saved? Well, first, Hector must know what opioids are. Say someone falls to the ground and hurts her knee. In this case, the body will release what are called endogenous opioids to help her out against the pain. These include endorphins, enkephalins, and dynorphin. However, an opioid is anything that binds to an opioid receptor. Therefore, there are opioids which come from outside our body but interact with the opioid receptors in the same way. These are called exogenous opioids. There are three opioid receptors to which they bind, mu, delta, and kappa receptors, and they are all part of a group of receptors called G-protein-coupled receptors, or GPCR. Let's view a model of this. This part is the receptor itself with seven helices which go through the membrane. On the outside of the cell, there is a cavity to which an agonist like an opioid binds. On the intracellular side, the receptor is coupled to a G protein, which has an alpha, beta, and gamma subunit. When an agonist binds, the G protein activates. The GDP molecule bound to the alpha subunit is released and replaced with GTP. The protein dissociates into the alpha subunit and the beta-gamma subunit, both of which can now interact with other protein pathways. For example, alpha interacts with adenylyl cyclase, and the alpha protein can stimulate or inhibit based on the type. This enzyme uses ATP to produce CAMP. CAMP is the secondary messenger, which is involved in many different responses. An opioid can use this mechanism to inhibit this enzyme and then prevent pain signals. Eventually, the body becomes dependent on and tolerant of the drugs, leading the body to want more. Addictions often begin with prescription drugs and then go out of control. This has led to an opioid crisis. To prevent misuse, people must only take the prescribed amount of drugs, not share medications, and stay educated on the opioid crisis. It is important to solve this crisis because as many as 128 people die each day from an overdose in the US. But how can Hector's friend be saved from an overdose? An opioid is an agonist, but there are also antagonists such as naloxone, which can bind to an opioid receptor in the same way, but not affect the G protein. Why is this important? Well, now that it is bound to the receptor, the opioid can no longer bind, preventing its effects. Knowing this, it is possible for Hector to save his friend's life. He just needs to be prepared and stay informed.